If you do something creative, creative people want to be there.
The murals no longer kind of became a thing for us, or even for the artists, it became these spots where people were creating life moments.
I was lucky. I grew up with art, but most people don't. And I think less and less people go to museums or galleries. And a theme that we have tried to always, you know, keep track of is art for all. We have a capacity to produce something with these brilliant artists. They literally live a gift to the city. Thank you, thank you, thank you for the gift of your time, your imagination, your creation, your political message. It doesn't matter, but thank you for leaving it for our city.
It's given people a deeper appreciation for the art form, and that has led to a lot more opportunities.
Artists that now have become our friends now have full-on practices based upon these mural festivals.
One of the biggest joys that I have is giving an artist for the first time that has never painted a mural an opportunity to do so.
A woman sent us a kind of a testimonial. And she said that her mother had had Parkinson's disease for so many years, and she took her to go see the murals after they were completed, and she said it was the best day that she ever had with her mom.
At first, I just wanted to break shit and piss people off. And at the end of the day, like now I'm like totally mesmerized by the experience of being a part of the process.
The festival is a very small percentage of the art that's getting done. It just happens to get the most amount of noise because it's all happening at once. But every single week, every single day, there's a new artist, there's somebody throwing up a wall, there's a new project, Anthony's getting hired for another job, Jeremy's getting hired for another job. The demand gets bigger and bigger, and I think that's something that we find a lot of joy is the demand for art is getting bigger in all of our communities.